So Shri, how do you really perceive this city?
So for me, the city has been a huge piece of land divided by the bridge. We have the old and the new.
And that's such an interesting way of looking at it, and it's from a broader lens. And what if we actually went deeper, somehow explore how segregated the spaces can be within?
I'm sure we'll find a lot of differences between each community in both these parts, and I think it'll be even more interesting to study these during using movement and music.
And I think music can be an interesting tool to play with over here, because film that can connect with everybody, and a social dance experiment would be a very interesting way to somehow explore how each space and community responds to it.
Through the given project, we wish to explore different pockets of the city and its public spaces, to connect with different demographics and witness how experiments like this may respond to their socio-political context. Through performance that aims to engage, the performers invite people to indulge in movement for about 30 to 45 minutes, exploring spatial configurations and music. African-American street dance culture inspired this, where music and dance were used as tools to express, and how it became an important part of their lifestyle. The nature of these art forms are very social, be it disco or hip-hop, where music makes people interact with each other. We were curious to put such a social dance setting to the context of Ahmedabad and see how people would react to it, and to study the segregations and differences in each street. Will we be able to create any connection, engagement, or could it be seen as provocative? And what really conforms for each context?
We conducted our experiments at Municipal Market, Chhara Nagar, Hollywood Basti, and Zen Cafe. We chose these four locations based on the difference in the demographics, cultures, and privileges of the communities who take these spaces.
Municipal Market is a place where people come to shop, hog food, and chit-chat. To dance within such gatherings where people from different backgrounds and age groups are present made us select the space. There was an initial hesitancy to perform, which slowly cultivated into a feeling of release for the performers, who were mostly women. The lines between spectator and performer blurred at various points, where gender and societal constructs became a pivotal factor. Men who were working, passing by, chose to watch the performance from a distance. Little girls selling keychains opened up to the idea of dancing freely and eventually took charge of the performance. Older women selling goodies urged the kids to dance and also busted some moves of their own. One of them told Srilakshmi that, "Since you have such a slender figure, dance looks good on you," expressing so much through her eyes. As facilitators and performers, there was a need to experiment yet also be acknowledged. What was interesting to see is that privileges and societal constructs were a consistent thought for us here, as each person would react so differently to music. For some, especially underprivileged children, moving to music came so naturally, while for many there was a resistance to respond to it based on conditioning. An idea of knowing through doing developed through this.
We had no idea a place like Chhara Nagar existed in Ahmedabad. It was shocking because we have been engaging with the artists in Ahmedabad and we missed out on this community, which is majorly driven by art and theatre. Chhara Nagar inhabits many denotified tribes, and the Habitual Offenders Act, which was earlier known as the Criminals Tribes Act of 1952, is imposed here. So people born in Chhara Nagar are tagged as born criminals. To give you a little backstory, the people of Chhara Nagar were alcohol brewers during the British era, which became the line of occupation for generations. We were at a community center with huge speakers, which is an open area surrounded by their houses. Initially, they were observing, however, it didn't take them much time to be involved and to make the entire situation their own. Dancing to songs of different genres wasn't much of a problem. However, they did relate more to indigenous and Bollywood music, but they themselves played a lot of songs that were not of Indian origin. It seemed like engaging in music and moving as a community was a practice in some form. As a moving body, we were very excited to dance in this new environment. However, there was some hesitation for sure. Maybe it was because of the group of men who only cheered on for female dancers. But people in general around us were very warm. Initially, the spectators were at a distance, but it didn't take long for the line between the spectators and the performers to diminish. Dance became celebratory and both the spectators and performers were trying to adapt to what was happening. People of all age groups were trying to let loose and let music take over. It was beautiful to see how, despite of the cultural differences between the spectators and the performers, music connected us all.
Our next location was Hollywood Basti, a slum area on the sides of a road which is considered to be one of the liveliest places in the city, with constant wedding or festival dances. Considering their familiarity with social dancing, we decided to engage in this space, thinking that they would be very much open to the idea of this experiment. What transpired was something starkly different. We started on the edges of the Basti, where before we could perform, a man called out one of the performers for a dance battle, and then proceeded to make very suggestive moves. A fear instilled for the performers, especially women, as the space started feeling unsafe. The kids in the area were also quite rowdy, showing middle fingers and saying very inappropriate things. There was a strange power that the community exerted, which was a huge contrast with the other locations. To overcome our fears, we decided to claim our space by moving further inside the Basti and performing, which made the environment feel safer as more people started engaging. For the community, there was a willingness to perform and claim their space. However, their presence was very dominating, a need to be seen and to be recognized. Some men kept pushing people inside the area to show their skills. One of them forced a woman to move, to which her response was to just stay still, not dance, yet also not leave the space. We had conducted a similar experiment in a different Basti where the engagement was unlike this. Some illegal activities such as alcohol brewing are common in these spaces, yet their response to dance is so different from one another based on their context and cultures.
Zen Cafe is a very chilled out place, unlike the rest, where people who wish to enjoy peaceful evenings or work visit. It's situated inside the campus of SEBT University and is exactly beside Ahmedabadni Gufa, which is a very famous art installation in the city. Music here wasn't the key element and we weren't allowed to play our music, and we went in as customers to ease into our experiment. We started to move to the music that was already playing, whose volume was very low. The people here at Zen were not willing to acknowledge the presence of the movers. However, they did notice what we were doing over there. The movers had some very interesting experiences. Some of them were used to the validation and acknowledgement from the previous experiences, so they found it very difficult to move at Zen, whereas some of them used the change of space as an inspiration for their movement. Their movement became fuller, bigger, and they were trying to take in the environment and moving to the sound of the leaves and all that. Shortly after, we were asked to leave and they said we aren't supposed to do street acts in an institution. You know, it isn't allowed. And it really made us ask ourselves what was so threatening about a group of people moving in silence in a public space which promotes art. So there was this negotiation between what is allowed and what is not.
There's a lot of value in doing an experiment like this, which we did not realize while getting into it. Even though music and form of movement are similar, how each society reacts differently is interesting, and what does it speak about the dynamics in place? If these things happen frequently, what would occur? Can repetition possibly lead to having dance as a part of people's lifestyle? And if this freedom is experienced regularly, Can it possibly bring a change in how people perceive art, their own bodies, lifestyles? The fact that we could enter someone else's space itself spoke about the privilege that we exercise. In each space, there was a negotiation of our position. We can never understand the experiences that communities with lesser privilege go through, and so can't they ours. And to accept that and to continue doing this experiment led to moments of uncertainty, unsafety, surprise, and outcomes that we could never expect. Our knowledge and experience about public spaces and the city has completely changed. We used to live in a bubble, and I guess knowing and doing truly came into effect. So much differs from street to street in terms of values, ethics, conformities, perceptions.
We definitely want to do more of these experiments. There is so much we have discovered about ourselves, the city and its people, which we could have never understood by means other than music or movement. The power of dance in each context is profound, and how it can connect with people despite backgrounds. Even though the spaces are segregated, music and movement mean a form of trust and connection which is intangible.